Hello dear students, welcome to my channel. In this episode, we are going to discuss definite integral, JEE mains and MCET type questions we will discuss. Let us have a discussion. The first question. Integral minus pi by 3 to 0, cot inverse of 2 by 2 cos x minus 1 plus cot inverse of cos x minus 1 by 2. Into dx. So how to do this type of problems? Integral minus pi by 3 to 0, cot inverse of 2 divided by 2 cos x minus 1 plus cot inverse of, after taking LCM, it will becomes 2 cos x minus 1 divided by 2 into dx. We know that from inverse trigonometry identities, tan inverse x is equal to cot inverse of 1 by x, or cot inverse x equal to tan inverse of 1 by x. So here I want to get formula form. The second term, cot inverse of 2 cos x minus 1 by 2, in terms of tan I am going to write minus pi by 3 to 0 cot inverse of 2 by 2 cos x minus 1 plus cot inverse in terms of tan. By using this formula I am writing. So tan inverse of 1 by this value. So denominator of a denominator, it will become a numerator. 2 by 2 cos x minus 1 into dx. And very important thing, the value of x, the value of x belongs to closed interval of minus pi by 3 to 0. The value of 2 cos x minus 1 is greater than 0, and that means x is greater than 0. This value is greater than 0. Whenever it is greater than 0, we have identity tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is equal to pi by 2. So by using this identity, this bracket value will become cot inverse of 2 by 2 cos x minus 1 plus tan inverse of 2 by 2 cos x minus 1. This value will become as pi by 2. So it will become minus pi by 3 to 0 integral. This value will become pi by 2 into dx, which is equal to pi by 2 constant you can take outside. Integral dx is x. Applying the limits minus pi by 3 to 0, which is also equal to pi by 2. First, in place of x, upper limit you have to substitute 0, minus in place of x, lower limit minus pi by 3. So, which is equal to pi by 2 into minus plus pi by 3, which is equal to pi into pi pi square divided by 3 into 2, 6, pi square by 6. Which is there in the second option. The next question. If a equal to integral 0 to pi cos x by x plus 2 whole square, then integral 0 to pi by 2 sin 2x by x plus 1 into dx. So first, then we have to calculate. Integral 0 to pi by 2 sin 2x divided by x plus 1 into dx. This value they are asking. Given a equal to 0 to pi integral cos x by x plus 2 whole square. But here pi by 2 is there. For what we have to do here, 2x is there, no? This we can assume some t or y, anything you can assume that. Put 2x is equal to some t. Differentiate with respect to x. So with respect to, yeah, yes, x you can write. So 2 into x derivative is 1, dt by dx. But here dx value is there, no? So dx make as a subject. So dx is equal to dt by 2. After getting the value of dx, whenever tx, 2x is equal to t, if you assume that, limits automatically will change, upper limit and lower limit. So upper limit, when x is equal to pi by 2, the value of t is equal to, x is equal to pi by 2, substitute 2 to get cancelled, pi, t is equal to pi. So lower limit, when x is equal to 0, t value goes to be 0. Therefore, this integral will becomes integral 0 to, lower limit is 0, upper limit is pi, sine, in place of 2x, you have to write t, sine t, divided by x value also. So 2x is equal to t, that implies that x is equal to t by 2 only, no? So now t by 2 plus 1 in place of dx, dt by 2. So take LCM and simplify. 0 to pi sin t divided by, take LCM here, 2 t plus 2 into dt by 2. So here 2 get cancelled, which is equal to integral 0 to pi 1 by t plus 2 into sin t dt. Here integration by parts you have to apply. By using integration by parts, first you have to decide which function is coming first function. T 1 by t plus 2, it is algebraic function. Sin t is trigonometry function. In Eilert formula, which is coming first function, by using Eilert formula, 1 by t plus 2 is algebraic, sin t is trigonometric, so it is coming first. So in definite integral integration by parts formula, first f of x, this is f of t, now this is g of t. So f of t into 1 by t plus 2 into integral g of t, integral sin t dt, applying the limits 0 to pi, minus integral 0 to pi f dash of t, 1 by t plus t, 1 by x derivative is minus 1 by x square, no? So 1 by t plus 2 derivative is minus 1 by t plus 2 whole square into integral g of t, that means integral sin t dt whole dt. So it will becomes what is integral sin t minus cos t. So it will becomes minus cos t by t plus 2, applying the limit 0 to pi. So here minus into minus plus, here minus is there, no? Again integral sin t, it will become minus, no? Minus into, ultimately minus only will come. Integral 0 to pi cos t divided by t plus 2 whole square into dt. After getting up this step, we will write it as, first in place of t upper limit you can substitute. So minus cos pi divided by pi plus 2 minus, in place of t lower limit, minus cos 0 divided by 0 plus 2 minus, by using variable change property, here in terms of t is there, no? We can write it as integral 0 to pi. Why we are changing that property is variable change property. Here we know that integral f of x dx is equal to integral f of t dt. This is called variable change property, integral a to b, integral a to b. This is integration variable change property. So wherever t is there, here also in place of t I am assuming that x. So integral 0 to pi cos x divided by x plus 2 whole square into dx. Since the value of integral 0 to pi cos x by x plus 2 whole square dx value is a. Since a is equal to integral 0 to pi cos x divided by x plus 2 whole square into dx. So now we will simplify this one. Cos pi value minus 1, minus into minus is plus 1 by pi plus 2 minus cos 0 is 1, minus into minus is plus 1 by 2 minus this value from the given information is a. Therefore, we can write it as 1 by 2 plus 1 by pi plus 2 minus a, which is there in the given options. It's the first option it is, which is there in the first option. The complete answer, we have to see that. Let us have a discussion. Next question. If y equal to f of x satisfies the relation integral 2 to x f of t dt equal to x square by 2 plus integral x to 2 t square f of t dt, then integral minus 2 to 2 f of x dx equal to options 0, minus 2, 2, 2 log 2. These are the options. F of x, y is equal to f of x is a relation satisfies the condition. What condition is given here? Integral 2 to x f of t dt is equal to x square by 2 plus integral x to 2 t square into f of t dt. So they are asking to calculate integral minus 2 to 2 f of x. First, you need to calculate f of x value. How to calculate f of x value? How to get that f of x value? If you differentiate here by using Leibniz theorem, differentiating on both sides, differentiating So here, if you differentiate, integration and the differentiation will be inverse process, both will be cancelled. So you will get, by applying Leibniz theorem, it will becomes f of x, again x derivative is 1, minus f of 2, 2 constant derivative is 0, which is equal to x square derivative is 2x divided by 2, plus here also Leibniz formula you can apply. Wherever t is there, we have to replace upper limit. Integration differentiation will be cancelled. 2 square into f of 2, again 2 derivative is 0, minus x square into f of x into x derivative is 1. Like this, you have to do the differentiation. So now, 0 into anything is 0, here also 0 into anything is 0, here 2, 2 get cancelled. We will get f of x equal to, here x minus x square into f of x. So here f of x term is there, here also f of x term is there, minus x square f of x, I am taking this side. We will get f of x plus x square into f of x is equal to x. From these two f of x, if you take common, so f of x into 1 plus x square is equal to x, which implies that f of x equal to x divided by 1 plus x square. This is about f of x value. They are asking to calculate integral minus 2 to 2 f of x into dx. Here observe that it is in the form of integral minus a to a f of x dx. We have properties in definite integrals. Integral minus a to a f of x into dx is equal to 0 if f of x is an odd function. Is an odd function equal to 2 times of 0 to a f of x if f of x is an even function. First we will check that whether it is even function or not. To decide whether it is even function or odd function, f of minus x you can calculate. F of minus x equal to minus x divided by 1 plus minus x whole square, which is equal to plus x square. So we can write it as minus, in place of x by 1 plus x square you can write as f of x. So f of minus x equal to minus f of x, that implies f of x is an odd function. Whenever we decide it is odd function, minus 2 to 2 f of x dx equal to 0, since it is odd function. Since it is an odd function, therefore the first option is the right option. The next question, if I1 equal to 0 to 1, integral 0 to 1, 2 power x square dx, I2 equal to integral 0 to 1, 2 power x cube into dx, I3 equal to integral 1 to 2, 2 power x square dx, and I4 equal to integral 1 to 2, 2 power x cube into dx, then the values, options are there. So now we will check that in between 0 to 1, in between 0 to 1 in every integral, in first two integral, we will check that the value of x lies between 0 and 1. 0 is less than x is less than 1. That means x value in between 0 and 1 it will take. That means either 1 by 2, 1 by 3, like these values it will be. So these values, based on this, the value of x square and x cube will change. So if you take x is equal to 1 by 2, 1 by 2 whole square, this is 1 by 4, 1 by 2 whole cube, 1 by 8, 1 by 4 is greater than 1 by 8. So we can get x square is greater than x cube. In between 0 is less than x is less than 1, x value lies between 0 and 1. The values of x square is greater than x cube. After that, whenever x square is greater than x power 3, obviously power rise to 2 here, 2 power x square is obviously greater than 2 power x cube. 2 power x square, 2 power x cube. So taking integration on both sides with limits 0 to 1, integral 0 to 1, 2 power x square into dx is greater than integral 0 to 1, 2 power x cube into dx. This value is equal to I1 is greater than, this value is equal to I2. So I1 is greater than I2, which is there in the first option. But here if you can take that only 0 to 1, if you verify I1 is greater than I2, we have first option. But another I3, I4 is also there, no? So we have to decide whether it is the relation I3 is greater than I4 or not. We will check. After that, we decide first option is the right option. So the value of x lies between 1 and 2. Then suppose x lies between 1 and 2 means it is 1.5. 1.5 means about 3 by 2. 3 by 2. If you calculate x square, that value is 9 by 4. If you calculate x cube, that is 27 by 8. We observe that x square value is 9 by 4. It is approximately 2.25. x cube, it is 27 by 8. It is approximately 8 threes are 24. So 3.3 something it will come. Obviously 2.25 is less than 3.75. So if you power rise also, x square is less than x cube. If we power rise to 2, 2 power x square is less than 2 power x cube, and take that integration on both sides with 1 to 2. Integral 1 to 2 2 power x square dx is less than integral 1 to 2 2 power x cube into dx. This value is I3 is less than I4. If you observe that I3 is less than I4 is not there in the option C. So, but I1 is greater than I2 in option it is there. So, first option is the right option. Thank you dear students for watching my channel. Please do subscribe to Maths with Panindra. Thank you dear students.